Jordan Borden. I'll play you. You got, wait, what you, what's it on, Players Lounge? I don't play for free. I haven't played for the Madden game in like 5 months. Hey, Jordan. Jordan, you know this is an actual game. You still owe me 100. Jordan, I know you hear me. I know you hear me talking.
Escaping the pressure right. And he overshot him incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there. That'll bring up second down.
Well, he certainly didn't waste any time throwing some deep passes here. But the defense, it wasn't unexpected. They told their secondary, be ready. You're going to be tested all night by this team.
First carry for Thomas Rawls. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. That'll going for a loss of four. And that'll force upon him a third and 14.
You got the first. I'm done.
Good for 15 and a first.
How many times do we hear that third down may be the most important down in football? And there's no better example than what we just saw right there. Forced to scramble, nose
in a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Falcons taking over on offense in just a second. And, you know, this year ended in disappointing fashion now. Last year was the ultimate version of heartbreak. But if you're a Falcon fan, was this one was tough to swallow as well, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because let's be honest about it. Losing in the Super Bowl, I don't care how you lose, you're in the Super Bowl. You're playing for it all. This team was supposed to be as good or better. Ultimately ended up 10-6, found their way in the playoffs, but didn't get the deep run as they had the year before. So you're exactly right. For Falcons fans, that's a tough one. But this is a team that's built to be good.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Cliff Averill able to get in there and drop him behind the line. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Now Ryan looking deep for Julio. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
I know exactly why he tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. The punter Boscher on now as he gets this one away. Now it's Lockett. Nearly a huge return, as it is still a very good one. 24 yards. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league for by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis, some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins. And about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks, DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names that could be out there as free agents. Third down, here's Rawls. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6-7.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne in there to sack him for a loss of 6. Before the offense changes hands here, let's look back at the Super Bowl February 5th. What a game. I know you were there calling it offensively, though. Impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles, the backup quarterback turned MVP, 373 yards, 3 touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off air, it was just a fluid game, not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game, and of course, people in attendance. It really.
And this is caught inside the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones. 37 yards, and the Falcons have taken the early lead. and take it in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Charles, earlier we talked a lot about Russell Wilson, what a great job he did last year in 2017 as Seattle's offense is working their way back onto the field. But they're probably going to need to find a running game to alleviate some of that pressure on Wilson, right?
Yeah, you think? I mean, my goodness.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. It's a big hook up there. Wilson to Baldwin. 41 yards. Play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Brooks Reed able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. He took a hit on that last play. Now let's see how he and the offense respond on second. They run it with Carson. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. Now it's Wilson. Flush to his right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And the return will stop right around the 25. So the football switching hands here in just a second. And, you know, Tom Brady, just to go off on a tangent for a second, may have lost the Super Bowl, but third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last nine NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl that same season, 0-9.
Yeah.
You go all the way back to Kurt Warner in, what, 1999, where he won the double?
We were going over that stat earlier. That is hard to believe.
But he would have been the MVP had the Patriots pulled that one out.
Yeah, he still has five rings, though, five Super Bowl titles for Brady. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. So it can't hang on, and as I watch it unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Dancing to his left. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A really good pickup of 28 yards. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Eluding the pressure right. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. A very solid gain of 27.
Julio Jones is off to a monster first half, but still, can he reach what he did against the Panthers in 2016? Didn't he go for a cool 300 in that game?
On the dot in week four, 300 yards. Oh, Matt Ryan had a pretty good game, too, threw for over 500. Only a yard that time, second and goal. On second down, here's Ryan. Escaping the pressure right. Touchdown, Falcons! Here's Bryant for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Here's Bosher to kick it away. Tyler Lockett now with a return. I want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalist for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
Play action. It's Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Wilson. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 75 yards. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. They were already down two scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies. A big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed because, let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over, this game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What, 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. Usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
On first down, Ryan. Flushed. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Cliff Averill in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
On second down, Freeman. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now look at this, fourth and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. Off the play fake to Rawls. Wilson. Flush to his right. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Pretty good running there. 9 yards. Sets up a third and one.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. And it's a Seattle Seahawks touchdown. And a
time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am, go ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
Before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald?
And that's caught inside the 35. And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. A big play there just before halftime. 49 yards. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good.
Well, Larry, I know it's late there in Orlando. This is a school night. Folks eager to get right back to the action here in the third quarter.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Fake to Freeman. It's Ryan throwing the out route and complete. It's Jones, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Play action. It's Ryan. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. That's caught inside the 20. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down at the 18-yard line.
I really don't think that Julio Jones could be happier right now. Plenty of catch opportunities in this game. He's converted them, and his team's winning.
And Matt Ryan's happy, too, to have Julio Jones on the other side of these.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times we talk about breaking teams down, and oftentimes just through a running game. These two, they can break a team down through the air.
And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Eluding the pressure right. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Fourth down. Here's Ryan. They still can't get it. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Time running out here on the play clock.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Adrian Claiborne in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
And that's the second sack of the game. But this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Wilson. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw, a free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. They go play action with Wilson. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Brooks Reed in there to get him again. The third time he sacked him here tonight. Back now in Seattle, Washington. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Off the play fake. Wilson. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. And that's caught inside the 35. It's a big hook up there. Wilson to Baldwin. 49 yards. Off play action. Wilson escaping the pressure right. And his throw here is incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Well, to say that this has not been his game is probably a big understatement. I mean, he is all over the place. Mechanics are off, not accurate, except if you're playing on defense, because
oh, no, he lost the football. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First down, this is Rawls. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
It's a loss of two, now third down. This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak, not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let them get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Flushed out right. And this is intercepted, and that should do